changes.
Hi guys.
You forgot to put Beyonce in there. Maybe not do that.
Hi guys. We're back with a new beat breakdown of a very special song for us, the remix of Hymn for the Weekend by Coldplay. Let's just dive right into it. We'll start with the verses. From above, you know you make. Listen to the vocals. It's not much processing on it. It's a little bit of autotune, EQ, and we have a nice reverb here. Sent from up above, you know you make. It's the one we always use. Yes, without the reverb. Sent from up
above. So this is the reverb from the Coldplay session that they had on the track.
Yeah, and we added this on to it. So, and if you look at the music. Couple of plucks. And one more. And I see we have
four plucks.
Two more. Just small plucks. The first one is, I think, is our the Massey. And the second one, you can see here, it's been frozen, so it's just audio, but it's from the Lush
101.
And the two others is Omnisphere and just some samples in Ableton. But when you listen to the plugs, you can't really hear the harmonies of the song. No. If you add the nice piano. Some nice melodies in both the plugs and but also in the piano. If you listen only to the piano, which is a Nexus with a little bit of compression, reverb, and another reverb at the EOS.
It's not even quantized. It's just played. It's actually played with the melody on the verse, and we added two plucks. When I was down, when I was
hurt, you came to lift me up. You can say that this is like the foundation of the whole remix, so to speak.
So that's how we always start.
Yeah.
We never start with the drums.
No.
Maybe we should try that.
But we like to use a lot of keyboards to make the song move forward, and rather than just use a lot of percussion. Because if you listen to the only the plucks, it's very syncopated, and it's also a little bit swing quantized. And if you add this keyboard here, it's Mbira is another African thumb piano.
We used to have one here.
It just creates a nice rhythm to it. And it's just like a sample in from Kontakt.
It's not in the percussion box
anymore. Okay. It's way quicker just to use a plugin.
Yes.
Yeah. On the second verse, you have this bass. Very simple. Also, I forgot your friends.
Yeah. This is my garden. It's that's how it sounds outside my house.
Yeah. If you hear it a little bit loud in the mix.
course it's much lower in the mix, just to create some texture around the music.
But on the on our album, which is maybe will be out when you see this or not, it's coming in at the end of January. We were talking about that in an earlier interview, that we had actually, we didn't think about it, but we have actually animals in all of our songs, but in, you know, different animals, birds, stuff like that.
Yeah.
We just love using animal sounds.
And if you look at the drums, it's pretty simple. You have a kick drum. You have some percussion. And an extra clap. A couple of claps and one more here, just to, like, for the feel. More stare. The drums are pretty simple, but it works in the context with the music. Drink and lose the drug. Oh, now I think I must be
my user when I was a... Yeah, there's so much going on in the synths, so that's half of the drums, really.
And on the chorus, kind of the build before the drop. On Chris's vocals, it's same as on the verses. We have the 2C B2 reverb. And got my feeling drunk and high. An overdub. Got my feeling drunk and high. So high, so high. So the effects is actually from the stems. So that's really good.
And we have this funny little lead into the chorus.
Yeah, listen. Yeah. It's just Chris's vocals that's been triggered in a simpler. And you can see here it's been looped to just stretch the notes, and if you have the glide on, it doesn't re-trigger the sample when you play the notes. So if you see it again with the MIDI, that brings us to the next section of the song.
Yeah,
the drop. And that was not the original drop we had on this.
We had song. Millions of drops. No, we had actually
had a few.
But we didn't nail it right away. We nailed more or less the arrangement, the harmony structure, everything was there. But we struggled a little bit with the drop, so we had to redo it a couple of times. But that was all because of, you know, we wanted to feel right before we send it out.
Yeah.
To anybody, so we have a few versions. Yeah, maybe you can show them.
This is the first version of the drop.
I don't think that would have made 500 million Spotify streams.
I don't think so.
To be honest,
sounds way better with this one.
We wanted it to be a little more catchy and simple, but then also have this really nice tail to it. When he sings, he goes up and up and up, and we wanted that part to continue even more up. We tried a couple of different ideas, and then we ended up, we kind of like, it was a little bit of an accident as well.
You were just playing around the keyboard and the starting point on the samples, and suddenly things started to sound right. And if you listen to the sample, it sounds like this. And it's just been triggered from the simpler. And we added to some simple EQs, a delay, and our favorite reverb, the EOS, and some sidechaining. So it's not much processing. And when you play in the simpler and have the glide on, when you play a new note, it doesn't re-trigger the sample, so it just continues. And if you listen to the drop melody in solo, and you see the MIDI air is actually played on the keyboard.
Yeah.
And here you see the nice thing when you hold the notes and don't release it, it just continues, the sample just continues. And on the end of the melody, there you have it.
Yes, it's but we play everything, yeah. We don't program it into the piano roll, we play everything, so sometimes we stumble on something that sounds good because we played it wrong or there's something else going on. Originally on the drop we had a different set of chords. We had almost the same chords, but we didn't go down on the bass on the chord, and we copied something wrong, and then we played it back and it was like, hang on, that's not right.
But
you know, it sounds better than what we had, so we kind of kept it in there.
If you listen to the third bar,
that was an accident.
So rather than having the major chord, we went down to the parallel minor chord, just to create a nice variation. And it really sounds so nice when you hear the melody in the in the drop.
It gives it the extra variation and niceness.
Yeah, the melody is kind of jolly, stupid, but it's so catchy and it's very melancholic, the chords. So it's kind of has this nice mix of different flavors. And on the second part of the drop, we just added a high string. And we dubbed dropped it with a synth. This sounds nice in the context. And on the drums, we they are also very simple, but we added this nice hi-hat that I really like. This is a standard 808.
Yeah. If you try to solo that hi-hat with one of the plucks, you can hear that the timing is different. Or is it? Pretty close. I would think
the hi-hats are a little bit more swing quantized.
It's a little bit more,
But this sounds nice together, so you don't have to always have the same swing quantize. I think on the plucks it was 41%. The hi-hats maybe up closer to 50. I don't know. But the nice thing about the plucks is that they are very rather rhythmical than melodic. It's like the wheel of the song. It makes everything move forward, and the bass is also very simple. It just plays the same.
You hit some nice notes there in the plucks that kind of makes it a little bit more melancholic. So
and on the drop, we chose not to use that nice melodic piano from the verses because it didn't work with the melody. We had just a straight. And with the pad. To create those kind of nice rhythmical and melodical counter melodies, we used a flute.
Oh dear, that's so tropical. I don't know what to say.
But just creates a nice flavor in the background. Yeah. Nobody hears it's a flute. And you also have this arpeggio.
Yeah, that's nice. It was one of the first tracks we actually came up with on the song, together with the piano.
And if you listen to the arpeggio, the flute, and the piano and the pad, and in the context with the music, it sounds really nice. Shall we move forward?
Yeah, I think we second verse is more or less the same thing.
Yeah.
We added like a couple of more tracks. Sometimes we add like one or two new elements in there.
Yeah.
We try to add new elements every 4 or 8 bars.
Yeah. We have a quick listen to the verse. It sounds more like the verse 1.
Yeah. But we have Beyoncé coming in there, and we had the first version we did was very quickly done. We sent it over, and then Chris Martin he called us back, and he said, "Well, guys, you forgot to put Beyoncé in there." So
I think it was more or less done, the remix. But
yeah,
he loved it. But this was kind of, guys, I think you've forgotten one thing, Beyoncé.
It was on the really, second verse. Yeah, was really embarrassing. We got asked to do that remix really early. I mean, we had heard the original, but we tried as much as we can not to hear it.
Mm.
So when it came on the radio, we just turned it off because we needed to be like fresh into the this song. And
and also the multi-track session we got, there were so many files. So I think we just threw in a couple of vocal files and this is it.
Yeah,
and then we forgot Beyoncé.
I'm very glad we put her in there because she sounds really, really good.
If you listen to her in solo. Cursing through a blur, life is a drink and your love's a bar. And this one we only added the reverb that we had on the verses with the Chris and just small EQs, very, very plain. And sounds so nice together with the lead if you hear them only in solo. I feel you coursing through my blood. Life is a drink, your
love's about to make the start. And she's also in there at the end, so that's she sounds really, I mean, she's the one that kind of finishes the whole song. I think it's actually both Beyoncé and Chris Martin, like underneath there.
But here we only used the original a cappella.
Yeah.
It just sounded so nice together, and we didn't want to change that balance. So.
And on the end, we didn't add much of new tracks, maybe some more drums, a couple of claps.
Yeah, a couple of claps and here and there. And on the synths, it's, you can see here it's
more or less the same.
And here we have some, this is called a weird effect.
Yeah. Yeah, that's actually from the session.
Yeah.
So that sounded really, really nice. Yeah.
So we got some some haze here and there. Hey!
A bunch of effects that we
whatever.
It's always something there.
Yeah.
Some white noise stuff.
Yeah, not interesting at all, but it just, you know, the basic stuff to add.
But we can quickly have a look at the master. On this song, we only used 3 delays and effects. Delays and reverbs, apart from what's already on the tracks. It's very simple. Yeah. We normally have a lot more, but didn't need it.
Yeah, but on this song, the vocals sounded so good with all the effects, so we didn't have the need to add so much to it.
But in here, there's actually a couple of lexicons, and we love those plugins. They are they're really good sounding, and they kind of remind us of old gear that we used to have in the studio by Lexicon, so that's why we used them.
I don't remember what we used it on, do you?
Not right now. No.
I listened to it solo.
Such a long time ago.
Maybe it was only on...
maybe there was just some synths going through them. I don't know.
Oh. It's just the vocals,
Something there.
I think it was...
Yeah, it's the ending of the drops. Yeah. And
it just, I think on one word, actually.
Yeah.
So, but on synths, we always put effects as an insert. So, but on vocals, we like to use synths. But on this song, it didn't need much effects. We go back to the mix bus, the master bus. It's simple. It's a glue compressor. It's Ozone 5 with a little bit of EQ, harmonic exciter, multiband dynamics, important for the sound, some imaging, and some EQ. And then we have this satin tape just to warm it up a little bit. At the end, simple EQ.
Little EQ. And a fun fact on this one is that we actually just kept it like that. And we didn't, because we were thinking of, should we mix this or should we get somebody to master it or should we do the mastering session ourselves? We do that many times, but on this, it just sounded finished.
Yeah.
So we just bounced it, and I think we clipped the master around 4 or 5 dBs, actually.
Yeah, if you see on the output here. It's nice. It's nice to clip a little bit.
Yeah.
Because the drum sounds better than everything.
Maybe not do that.
Yeah.
You know, don't clip 6 dBs, but...
If it sounds good, it's good, but don't clip just to have loudness. No. That's not going to work because it's going to be taken down. So, but do it for the sound.
Yeah.
Yeah. And just at the end, we can just listen what the MixBus plugins do. This is without the plugins. You can hear from the drop. You hear that the kick drum is very loud, but when you add the compressors on, everything is glued together.
And the bass drum is still a little loud, but when we clip everything at the end there, then it kind of controls it.
Yeah.
That's it. I think we've covered... We haven't covered anything very specifically in detail, but we can get back to that if anybody wants to hear any more.
They can just write in the comments and we can
reply. Any questions of how we do this or that, but I think it's pretty simple.
Yeah.
And we'll see you soon again with another one.
Yeah. Bye.